Welcome back, StarCrafters! Today we're going to continue our coverage of the Idra Huck rivalry match from our Dallas Pro Circuit opener. Last game, Idra tied up the best of seven series at 2-2 with an incredible Hydra Spinecrawler all-in. Game 5 would prove to be a decisive game in the series, placing the winner just one game away from taking the match, so let's take a look.
And we are back again. Positions are identical, EG's Idra spawning as the blue Zerg in the bottom right corner, and in the top left, Liquid Huck as the red Protoss player. You know, I honestly think that Huck would be wise to just try to build those initial gateways at the bottom of the ramp, get a little bit earlier of an expansion. We've seen a lot of people try to pull that off, because I think Idra's consistent loss point is those early gateway pushes, like 5-6 warp gate pushes on two bases.
I actually really like that idea, especially considering how Idra has been opening up. He hasn't been going with that super early speed. If he has Zerglings out, it's usually just a couple of handful, try to get a peek up there. And that could give him a little bit of a preemptive stoppage on information gathering from Idra. And, quite frankly, also puts you a little bit closer to your opponent should there be an opportunity to actually use some aggression.
We do see Huck swinging up into the main, going to immediately begin harassing Idra. And again, I'm always leery of a player who's trying to cross through the center of those mineral lines. And look at this. There's a lot of worker pairs going on, such as these two workers both splitting up on this mineral patch. Huck wants to sneak in between and disrupt that. Idra going to respond by planting an early pool. Does not want to get blocked at his hatchery, so he's just going to go ahead and build the pool, assuming that Huck will do so. And Huck needs to be a little careful, because last game easily let Idra take his natural expansion.
Yeah, that's true, and it's something that you've got to definitely be aware of. Here we go once again, the fight here at the natural. Last time Idra was able to defeat that probe, get his expansion down with no problem. Going to try to go for it today at 100, but we'll have to move back.
Oh!
And actually moves through the drones via the mineral trick, but unfortunately does not pay off for him, and the hatchery goes down.
First scout drone heading out for Idra right now. Huck is adding his cybernetics core, just creating that nice little wall at the front of his base. No second gas has been taken quite yet. One zealot coming out, and no doubt a second assimilator will be coming soon, but will Huck end up going for that Stargate opening? If he does, I would not mind seeing some sort of Void Ray or Phoenix play, but I just think that he should commit to it if he does decide to go for that path.
Right. We'll never know. I guess we'd have to ask him why that opening exactly went the way it did, but so it was written. And there is a zealot at the front. Warpgate research going to get started here fairly soon. Wondering how the extractor's going here for Idra. Looks like it is about ready to complete too. And this drone inside the base of Huck, just continuing to gather some information. Chrono boosting out now a stalker again. Take care of that drone and continue on with his strategy. Couple Zerglings out, checking around the base. And we see two drones on gas collecting that. He'll get the speed at 100-100 and then move on from there.
Drone dies, splits in half. Huck now moving out with a zealot and a stalker, a sort of push we haven't seen Huck do in a very long time. Two gates moving out right now. There's one Zerling in the center of the map. Huck, actually, one of the games I've seen Huck take off against Idra was with this kind of Zealot Stalker push. Huck's very good at controlling both of those units, and because the Stalker is faster than the Zerglings without speed, he can continue to poke pretty freely, but it looks like all Huck's going to do is move out, force links to be made, and move right on back.
And speed is on the way, forced a couple more links to come out here, but Idra pretty confident that he could continue to drone up. We see three more drones on the way, another Overlord as well, and gateways, how many? Went down just to three gateways now for Huck with a Warpgate research about ready to finish, and there it goes. Gateways will open shortly. The Nexus goes down yet again, and was it spotted? Not quite. Don't see it actually see it shimmering there, so it kind of looks like maybe he did.
So at the very least, Idra, I mean, you can see on the mini-map that there's a little plotch around there. So he will know that there's an expansion up, but based on this placement from Huck, would not be surprised to see some gateways go down at the front. Again, I think that these early pushes with just gateway units are a real struggle for Idra. However, I think Huck is going to still be favoring to just try to win in the late game with Blink Stalkers, with the Colossus tech, with just the big death army ball that Protosses love to make. Huck still adding on a bunch of sentries. We will very much so have to see what kind of play Huck wants to make.
Speed's finishing Roachorin as well. We do have some spine crawlers going down at the front of Idra's base. And yeah, that sentry count very, very high here for Huck as he's going to also get that Nexus up. And we have two more gates going down now for Liquid Huck. A lot of energy on that initial Nexus. Ling's continuing to poke here, and pretty kind of slow and steady game for both players, especially after a stoppage at 1840. You know, both players want to obviously be safe. This game will mean a lot in the grand scheme of things, but especially for keeping that momentum going for a second win.
So it does look like that Idra's going for that aggressive play. He's getting the burrow and tunneling claws. This could potentially be very dangerous for Huck if he doesn't get some sort of detection, but I'm more worried about Idra because the 5 gateway push from Huck is about to get ramped up. Huck does have that forge down, so he can build an emergency cannon if he needs to. Moving across the center of the map with those stalkers, there is a pylon going down not in the middle of the map, so that means that Huck can't quite do the reinforcement that he might want, but he's really getting aggressive, and there's the pylon going down just on the edge of the creep.
And this is going to be interesting as the sentries are going to kind of put themselves up. Wow, he's sending all of his stalkers back. Is there something that I missed there? No, I don't know. He's left all of his sentries right out here.
Uh-oh.
They
uh-oh.
Are going to Tunneling Claws. I do not think that they're in his observer right here. Oh, my God.
Oh, he's going to pop out right underneath, and he gets all the sentries. There's the Guardian Shield going down. Huck trying to spam as many force fields as he can, but he is just going to pick off all of those sentries. And Huck is on move. The burrow, unburrow, and there's the good game. The 5 warp gate gets denied.
Wow.
Oh my, burrow, Idra had the perfect counter to Huck's Sentry Heavy 5 gate. And with that win, he's just one game away from taking the series. Make sure you guys join us tomorrow to see if Huck can tie it up or if Idra is going to walk away the champ.